First ride of the week on Tuesday, Skyline. Joined by Dr. Baum with me. We're on pedals. What do they call them? Analog bikes?
We suffer.
Yeah, definitely suffered up here today, but it's going to be fun going down. Beautiful weather. I think I might go to State Fair later. Here we go. Ready for this?
Let's do it.
We're on the right bikes. Oh, no, Epic. Man, this thing is nice down that. This is a crossover. I got washed away. Yeah, the rain took it down. That's that ridge I was talking to you about.
That's nice, I like that slide. Thank you.
Nice.
Oh yeah.
Good one, huh?
Yeah.
Have you done that?
Yeah. That's the first time I've done that without stopping and looking at
it. Have you gone down that one?
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that one. This one is so much steeper than it looks on GoPro. Oh God, I heard that car coming.
Thank you.
Yeah. We're at the Skyline COVID-19 test facility, AKA the Swapmoto Life van.
See, these are the instructions.
Oh, is it the shove all the way to your brain one?
Yeah.
Oh, I've done that.
Yeah. Pretty much.
So
okay, patient's not trying to reach the pulse here. Keep inserting until the eyes water and turn bloodshot. Rotate through the loose swab. So what I got to do?
Oh, it's a deep one then, huh?
Yeah, it goes all the way in.
Yeah. Yeah, I had to do that at Supercross.
So
when one of your best buddies is a surgeon. You have access to these things.
I'm a surgeon, not a infectious disease guy.
Shouldn't you be wearing a hazmat suit testing me right now? Well, I got plenty of liquid in my nasal passages right now from mine.
Okay.
Oh. Yeah, that's going to remember.
Okay, I'm going to do this one. Better you than me, dude. Okay.
Oh, not fun.
No, it isn't. Okay, so then we peel off, pull that. I think this is what we use here. We'll see. Five times. One, two, three, four, five.
And squeeze it, like squeeze
it. So by rotating against the extraction valves while squeezing the sides of the vial. Oh, so I'm supposed to squeeze the sides of the vial.
Squeeze the juice out of the Q-tip.
Squeeze the sides of the vial. Just properly discard the swab. Goes in the back of Don's
van.
Okay, where's the little
top?
Hang on to this.
COVID cocktail.
Okay, click it.
This is snap.
I don't know. I'm not sure I'm qualified to do this. Come on, you mother.
There you go.
Okay. Click. Tap. Okay. Invert the extraction vial onto the sample vertically above the sample well. Squeeze the jump out. Allow 3 drops of sample to fall into the sample well.
That's the one?
I think so. Okay, count. 1, 2, 3.
Okay.
Okay, 10 minutes. Set the timer.
Minutes. So I passed. I'm all right. We're good to go to Houston. Alright, I need you to test something for me today.
Alright, let's go.
Yeah? You're just gonna go, oh, it's fire, it's fire. Everything to you is fire.
No, I tell the truth sometimes.
Come on, you're gonna test us. Yeah, have you been on the internet today?
The internet.
You gotta. Can you put some laps in those for me?
Yep. Cool.
You know, I'm not gonna ride today, so I can't. You can't test the lens durability because I won't be blasting you in the face like normal. But.
Hey, I like these. I'm
trying
them out. Power
bomb. Okay, yeah. The frame has flames.
But the frame looked the frame looked good.
Yeah.
Hey, look, he still ain't up. Look at that. Look at that flame.
Was it like 3 laps?
Oh, yeah.
He spelled it wrong. It's CH. Chub Daddy.
Yup.
That's the program right there.
Where?
Right there.
Oh, see.
Right there. Hey. That's what the tacos get you.
For what?
That's a product of Tuesdays.
Nope. You know what? 6 months from now, I'm going to be skinnier than everybody. I'm finished go training.
You're going to start crack again?
Yep.
When you scrub so hard, your pants pop open.
You need everything.
Yeah.
When he hit the clutch for the fifth time, his pants just popped open.
That's true, man. Lay off that thing.
Right?
Hey, no, you know what? Well, that's why he just bought me a new clutch.
Yeah, I had a pretty good clutch.
But it's all right.
All right, so tell me about the goggle.
The goggle works really good.
Not the gargle, the goggle. Let's see.
Hey, man, you know, I already put them away. They look so good. Yeah, you know, it's 100 FMF. I love it. You know, I already rock 100s, and I think it's a good go together. FMF already on the pipe, so I'm in. So make sure little D know that.
Well, what do you think of the design compared to 100?
The design
a little extra, right?
Yeah, look, they did a little extra. I like this part. The however you call it, but it's good. I like it. You'll start seeing me in it more often.
Oh yeah?
Oh yeah.
Oh, you use the tear off.
Yep. I'm just now starting to learn how to, cause I don't like to take my hand off.
Oh geez. Take everything else off.
Yeah, I don't take my hand off in the air, but I just started.
Sorry,
so
what were you doing in Kansas?
Oh, just driving. I like getting on a plane.
I thought you were in Oklahoma.
I went to 3 places. Because you know why? Ain't nobody in the airport and I can just walk right to the plane. It's like getting in the car now. No one wants to know.
And what were you doing? You just in shopping malls everywhere.
Yep.
In the woman's lingerie section I saw. Why are you filming that G-string on the mannequin?
That was Ethan. He was like, hey, get down with this. Get swapped. He always wants to get you now.
Shit. Ethan, you drawing crooked dicks on my car.
Yeah.
So, does it get the Scrub Daddy seal of approval?
Yup.
Go see him. FMF vision, baby.
I see it live.
Show me that thing again, your little brace.
I know.
Over here?
You're a little guy. Can you seat bounce that aggressively?
I guess. I mean, I find a way to, but my dad's got the fix, so we're feeling good so far. Just one off those things. Wow.
No breaking a BVR part.
Nope. He's got him dialed.
So it's Wednesday. We're in Altadena. Gonna ride Brown Mountain in El Prieto. And somebody's Kyle Perner,
yeah.
Big Air Todd, shock with a big Kiefer testing test rider. Oh, what are you wearing, dude?
I gotta go.
Are you wearing a tight jersey and baggy pants?
Hey man, listen.
God,
I do not walk the beaten path.
Hey, are you colorblind? Like, do you see color?
I don't think he does, dude.
What's wrong with you guys? What do you have? An orange helmet, a red and yellow thing, you have blue socks, a yellow bat. I mean, there's no coordination, color coordination at all.
Are you wearing the shorts just to appease me?
I thought maybe today, since we were all going together,
I would wear these shorts, which, by the way, are way too big. And they're going to be over my knees, and they're going to
bust. What are they, 36s?
Yeah.
Why would you order 36s?
You got me 36s back when I was fat.
Oh.
You're not fat anymore?
Well, no, I mean, I'm still fat, but...
But wait. Oh, dude, I'm not... We're going to start a weekly feature called What Are You Wearing with Hoppa?
Dude.
But anyway, we are in Altadena, where I grew up. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the house I grew up in as a child. When I lived here, I had no idea how amazing these mountains were. So yeah, this was my parents' house. I'll tell you, this pine tree used to be sick. My dad and his friend Mr. Ogawa crafted it into a bonsai tree. Nice lawn, guys. But check this out. Can you see that? I made myself. There you go. And my dad poured that little walkway. And at the time, I think I was sick, but he brought me out in the front yard to check it out. But he wrote my name in it. Didn't mean that much then, but it's pretty cool now. But yeah, they sure have let our house go to shit. I don't know what's this white fence, what that's supposed to accomplish. Anyway, bucket list is to buy that house back and retire in it when I'm even older than I am now. I'm in Altadena, California, where I grew up. Across the street from my childhood home was basically a canyon that led into the mountains. So right now I'm climbing a trail called Brown Mountain Road, almost to the top. I think it's like, hey, maybe 4 miles to top. But in the 90s, when I first started mountain biking, I pretty much did it to do something with my dad. Because for some reason, at like 68 years old, he got interested in mountain biking. So we weren't in it for the exercise or the suffering, but just the fun. So we used to have my mom drop us off at the top of the mountain, and we'd ride down from way up there back home. Anyway, later in the 90s, I started climbing this road with my good buddy Forrest Hayashi. Before we'd go to work together at Cycle News. Back then, this was a legit fire road. And you see cars on it sometimes. But it, I want to say the whole area burned down in the early 2000s. And this became kind of a degraded fire road / single track. Thankfully, the single track down is still super fun. This climb's never been fun, but the down definitely makes it worth it. And anyway, came today with my buddies Kyle and Hoppa. I'm riding my new Specialized Stump Jumper Evo, which is such a nice bike, but definitely doesn't climb as good as my Levo e-bike. I'm trying not to ride that thing now. My New Year's resolution is to lose some weight. I raced that Grand Prix at Glen Helen last Sunday, and I got fourth. Glen Helen gives you these cool trophies where I guess they have a photographer taking pictures of everyone. And if you place, they print out a photo of you right after the race is done and add graphics to it and give it to you in this cool little glass frame. Anyhow, bro, the spare tire I had hanging over the front of my O'Neill pants was horrifying. I almost didn't want to take the trophy home. Definitely not going to display it. As cool as it is, but yeah. So, New Year's resolution is to cut some weight, enjoy the suffering on a bicycle a little bit more, and stop committing those electric sins. Whoa, bro. Watch the tree. Steer wide. Steer wide, you got it. Oh, come on. Oh! You fucking held me up. Yeah. Oh, Hoppa's walking section.
That's what happens when you talk shit.
Maybe so. Probably scratch my new bike. Whoa. He's got it. Must be the new bike.
Oh yeah.
This is like that Grand Prix section.
What'd you say?
That was like the GP section of Glen Helen.
Yeah.
There's three more. God, that's so fun.
Dude, I'm like sweating.
So we're now at Kawasaki headquarters. Picking up a KRX 1000. Dr. Wilson here. His medical grade mask.
Yes.
How'd surgery go today?
Fantastic. Here at Kawasaki.
DMV and get us another one.
Oh, that's
green sticker. Where do I need a green sticker?
You gotta have a green sticker.
Why doesn't it get stuck on it?
Because we use them for being
a
dealer.
Multiple.
We can use them for multiple vehicles and stuff like that and everything. But please, please, please do not lose that.
Isn't there a glove box?
Yes. Yeah. And that's where I recommend putting it. Yep. It also's got one of our insurance cards in there. It's got my card in case anybody.
It's got insurance? It comes with insurance. You realize I'm Asian.
Yeah.
Japanese insurance.
This looks like trouble.
Back over where I think it's going?
Hey John, you got another 10 Oh, got it.
Hey John.
Yes sir.
So there are two models, correct?
There's Terex. We have a couple different models of Terex. So, but basically two. This one's more of what you call more of our sport edition and mm-hmm. everything. The other one really has done well for us in the years past. It's mm-hmm. an 800cc where this is bigger and everything. Uh-huh. It's two completely different platforms and everything. Okay. This one, you know, as you've driven it before, is a little bit more sporty. But it's a lot of fun. Yeah, and
You know what? I've only driven it a tiny bit. Most of the time, I've been holding onto that oh shit bar.
Oh, really?
Scared for my life, but you know.
Was Donnie driving then?
No, Jeremy. Jeremy was trying to scare me at, what was that called?
King of the
Area BFE.
Oh, BFE,
yeah.
Well, BFE is pretty interesting, isn't it?
Yeah.
That was a fun trip, though.
I did a poker run with Donnie at Havasu. Yeah.
That was actually really fun.
Did a quad just go in that trash can?
Yeah. Well, we. What we have is sometimes what we call is destroyers.
Yeah.
And what they are is it's kind of the first ones that come down the line and everything.
With no VIN number.
And
right?
then we have to destroy them at the end and everything. Because they basically have no VIN. Uh-huh. And they may do some testing on it and change and everything.
See, I have some friends that would argue that all quads belong in a VIN.
But yeah, no, it's a lot of people, when you first come here and you start seeing them get cut in half or stuff like that. But then you're actually glad because it makes room for newer units and stuff like that and everything. But there's so much here, you know, and so much room and everything. The adjustable seat, adjustable, you know, steering and everything. It's got your seat belts, you know, and everything. It's got your high, low. It's very easy to read the dash here and everything.
Yeah.
That's one thing that people have really liked is our dash. Yeah. It gives you so much info and everything. It's something that people have.
Mm-hmm.
I keep on hearing that from consumers and everything.
Okay, so yeah, this is
our 2021 Trail Edition.
So is the Trail Edition the same basic platform that Jeremy's been racing and stuff?
Yes, but this one comes with the Nerf bars and stuff like that. And comes with a few other different little things, mm-hmm. but it has a little bit of extras like that. And then we put the mirrors on there for you because, you know, we want you to be able to see Donnie in the back or something like that.
He's tie down back here. Cyclery, world's best bike shop, grumpiest owner, dropping off my babies back here. Just gave them a wash. New Stumpy Evo, Turbo Levo. He is going to swap the forks. So I've got these limited edition root beer forks that are hard to get. And these black Fox factory forks. Problem is that's a 160 and that's a 150. But because Mike's so good, he's gonna be able to swap the lowers for aesthetic reasons. Because I think root beer will look better on a black bike than it does on a flow orange bike. That looks like an MXA helmet. You know, the Xerox factory. It's the garage. Sleater's packing his life up here.
Yes.
Moving to Oz.
Yeah, this isn't the way that I like to have my friends over.
12 days?
13 days today.
13 days. You're turning in your stars and stripes. And Has it taken this long? Because you were going to move a couple years ago. Has it taken this long for your visa?
When I left KTM, I decided to make the move. And then my visa took like... It said 8 to 18 months.
Oh.
And then it took like 18 months a day. So in that it was 18 months I was going crazy in the apartment. So we bought this beautiful home.
Yeah.
And just things have changed here in the States. And Sarah hasn't got to see her family for almost 2 years because of travel.
Because of COVID, yeah.
And the kids haven't been in school. And I don't know. I'm going for it. Like, yeah. I love America. I love being a California guy. My friends and family, I'm going to tremendously miss here, but it's time for a new adventure. I've only cried like 15 times in the last week. But no, it's exciting. And this is,
you know, though, dude, let me tell you this. When Megan went to school in Japan, I was a wreck, right? And about 3 days into it, I realized that with FaceTime and text and all that, the world is so small now.
Yeah.
Like, back in the day, you couldn't text someone in Japan, you know? Now you could text them. You could send them pictures. And
yeah.
Like, and social media makes the world smaller, too, so.
My father-in-law, Tony, hasn't seen her daughter in 2 years, but me and my wife, and hasn't seen his grandkids in 2 years.
Yeah.
And he sees them every day on FaceTime. And yeah. he grows more love for them every day. Yeah. I've seen them, so. Like I said, I'll see my parents off to get their technology skills up to par, and I'll miss my Swapmoto Life family and all my riding buddies. But we're a flight away. I have some stuff planned when travel gets back to normal. Like, Mammoth's going to be like a thing. Vet World says like June, November. I'll be back and forth.
Oh, like, I'll build you bikes.
Yeah, exactly. So, no, it's been a hell of an adventure building a name for myself with this community. And I promise I won't make the California American crowd look bad in Australia, that's for sure.
What do you think? Do you think you're going to adapt the Aussie accent?
No, I won't do that because I talk shit about guys like in their 30s and 40s move to Oz and create an accent. I do use the slang. Like, yeah. If I'm going to go to the gas station, I'm going to the servo, just because that's what they call it. They don't call it the gas station. I'm anxious to see how the boys develop an accent, you know.
We're gonna give you like Dean Wilson all messed
up. All Spanglishy Aussie accent, but it's gonna be a hell of a ride. I have a lot of emotion, nervous, excitement, anxiety. But
so, okay, when you were gonna go, then you started PNG and you weren't gonna go, and then you bought the house. Like, did you know you were gonna go when you bought the house?
No, we were pretty rooted, to be honest, and we were happy.
The COVID thing was like the last straw.
Is like Queensland, for example, is kind of open in Australia, like open normal. Like, Brisbane has masks, but Queensland doesn't have masks. The kids are in school. It's more about my kids and my family, and I can adapt. I feel like riding is riding to me now. It's not racing and trying to accomplish things. It's the enjoy of watching my kids ride and being there. So I can do that in Australia. I don't have to have perfect Glen Helen or perfect Kahia. So the COVID thing gave us a reason financially too. Our house doubled in price in a short period of time, and equity is nothing if you don't do something with it. So I have to make some changes. And the PNG thing is an amazing thing that I built with my own two hands, and I am so proud of it, of anyone that supported me, and anyone that I just hope that when I go to Australia, that it continues to flourish here, and that the crew there is able to find someone to take my shoes here and fill them. But you know, it's a great product. I use it daily. Family comes before business.
Yeah. So are you moving to that part of Australia that has like zero COVID?
Yep.
Really?
Yeah. Queensland.
So you'll have to quarantine for 2 weeks there, right?
Yeah. 10 to 14 days. We're actually on a government flight to Australia. So it's only citizens and residents. I have my residency in Australia, and my kids are citizens, and obviously Sarah's a citizen. So we will land in Australia, and we don't even know where we go. They actually just take you in a bus or a car, and they put you in a hotel or an apartment, and you stay there for, there's rumors that it's 10 days for the government flight and 14 if you're on like a third party, Fiji Air or Air New Zealand. So I moved my flight up 2 weeks to be on the government flight with Sarah and the kids, and that makes me feel a lot better about the situation.
Cool. Well, we're gonna miss you, homie.
No, I know.
All right, Mace. Are you excited to move to Australia?
Yeah.
What are you most excited about?
To see my puppy and my uncles.
Yeah.
Because they're all I haven't seen them in 2 years.
Yeah. That's good, man. A kid that values his grandparents.
Yeah.
What about moto and stuff out there? Are you excited about that?
Yeah.
You gonna be the fresh, new, fast American kid on the scene?
Yep.
Yeah?
Yeah?
Yeah. Cool. How about you, Noah? Is there gonna be hip-hop classes down there?
No.
No. They don't have hip hop in Australia?
I don't know. Maybe.
Maybe? Because that's your thing, right?
No.
Not anymore?
Scootering and soccer.
Soccer. There's a lot of soccer down there. Yeah. Do you have an Australian accent yet? Can you fake it?
Not barely. I'm not really good at it, but Mason can. He thought he was born in Australia.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So what about you, Mrs. Slee? Are you excited to go home?
Yeah, I'm very excited.
Yeah? Haven't seen your parents in a while, huh?
Yeah. It's been a long time.
What are you going to miss most about California?
My friends.
The ones that you make look bad on Instagram?
Yeah, my friends. The snow. The snow in the winter.
The snow?
Time.
Doesn't snow down there, huh?
Down south.
Yeah, down south.
Yeah. What about the 91 freeway? You gonna miss that?
I know. I don't leave. I don't go past Clinton Keith and the 79. Oh, yeah? I stay in my bubble.
So, what's life gonna be like when you get there? Like, is it gonna be
a lot
higher? Higher level? Like, you big pimping in Australia?
No. We're poor.
Oh, come on.
We're poor. We're homeless, carless.
Yeah. So, are the luxuries of the United States the same down there?
Like they're cheaper here.
Cheaper here?
Uh-huh.
No, but I mean like...
Range Rovers and...
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. No, they're way... They're like double the price most.
Down there. Mm-hmm. What about the fancy handbags that you carry and stuff?
Oh, I don't care about fancy handbags. No.
No, okay. All right.
I don't care about that stuff.
Well, guys, I'm certainly going to miss my extended Sleater family. But as I just told Mike, social media, texting, all that stuff makes the world smaller.
Yep, it certainly does.
So, how do you say goodbye in Australian? G'day.
See you later, mate.
Ninety-seven point seven.
That's cold, isn't it?
It's a little chilly.
It's because
it's
cold here.
It's cold outside, and it's cold here. Yes, it is, sir.
Ready?
I'm ready. That felt nice. COVID test. Got my credential. And I got my driver Anton. He lets me in. Twan Diggity!
What's up?
How are you?
Good.
Good to see you, buddy.
It's good to see you.
It's been what?
Mini Major.
Mini Major, yeah. Mm-hmm. So last time I saw you, we were in
Georgia.
Atlanta eating terrible food. Can we eat something good now?
Yeah, what would you like?
Anything but Zaxby's.
Would you like, I found a juice and like health food store.
Yeah, that's
are we
fine.
Doing New Year's resolutions?
Sure. Well, we got dinner with the Moto Concepts crew tonight.
Okay, what time?
7 or 6:30.
Okay.
So just something to hold us over.
Perfect. We'll hit it.
And COVID Supercross sucks. These are like the only two semis that don't have walls. You want to just move it around? I'm shooting video.